Hi, Carl. Just decided to do a little video for you, so I wasn't really quite sure what to do this time, but the one pedal I use more than all the others, really. I mean, every time I turn the rig on, I use the loop station. Yeah, it's one of my oldest pedals, my old Boss RC2. There's a lot nicer versions of this now, where you can save all the tracks that you record, which is really handy, because there's only 11 slots on this that I can save, so I'm constantly... You know, you make your stuff up and then you run out of slots and then you delete something and forget what you've made up, you know what I mean? So, but I use it, because I play on my own, my time is pretty poor. So I use a drum machine a lot. And it also helps, just trying to put textures together. You're not stuck with one line. You can lay something down with the acoustic, or you can put a bass line down, or, you know, a couple of different guitars and see how they sound like mixed together. And that's quite interesting, and it just keeps you wanting to play, and keep yourself inspired a bit, you know. And like I mentioned before, you can put a bass line down. I've got you set up a beat, and then I use the POG 2. Let me turn off the delay. The POG 2 I've got set up with it's just one octave down. Turn the volume on your guitar down a little bit, and you get like a pseudo bass sound. So it just doesn't sound like, you know, completely like a bass, but it's close enough. So, but if you have your volume up full, that can it can get really boomy very quickly, especially when you're layering on top of it. So it's good just to keep it toned down a bit, and a little bit of reverb, or just run it dry, just so it doesn't get too much in the mix later on. So I'll start off with a drum track, and then we'll. Let's see how we get on. Idea. Obviously tons of mistakes in there, but if I'm trying to learn a solo or a piece of music, it really helps me where I can set a blank canvas for the track up and then practice over the top and just repeat it and repeat it and repeat it until I get closer and closer to the final thing that I'm looking for. It's to me, it's better than playing over the CD, because you're not fighting with the solo that's already been recorded. So, but anyway, that's what I do. If you can get hold of one of the newer ones, I think it's an RC20, something like that, then it's got, you know, a ton of recording time, and then you can USB the recorded loops off it and save your ideas. You know, if you come up with a really good riff, then you can save your ideas and have a bank of ideas on your computer, which is a really great idea. Anyway, buddy, I shall speak to you soon. Hope you enjoyed. Cheers.